Joan Salvado, housewife and mother, lives in Florida, not far from some very good bass fishing. From tackle demonstrations through to casting lessons, if it has anything to do with fishing, it's part of Joan's job, for she is a Garcia girl. And a Garcia girl is as much at home with tackle in her hands and an airboat beneath her as she is in a supermarket or on the dance floor. The Everglades and the wild backcountry have become a very real part of Joan's life. She knows the swampy depths and the winding water trails that will take her back into the lonesome areas where the biggest bass are likely to be found. There are main traffic lanes for water travel throughout much of the Everglades, with well-marked signs and stakes that enable any fisherman with a good boat and a good memory to drive deep into these great unsettled areas and then follow these main routes back to the marina again. A knowing driver in an airboat can turn off the main routes, however, and venture deep into the seemingly endless expanse of marsh grass and lily pads. A wild world that may be mild and beautiful at the start of a trip, but can turn grim and foreboding for anyone who fails to remember that unmarked route back home. Joan's explorations have located many secret hideouts for bass, and when she drives the airboat up into the reeds just hard enough to hold it there, she's picked a spot she can count on to give her some action. Joan likes to fish by wading. The wading angler moves quietly and covers a lot more water, more than if she had stayed aboard the airboat. In the beginning, the water is fairly open, and Joan pins her hopes on a slender floating plug, a lure that's fun to watch, and one she can count on to take its share of bass. Time to make every cast count. Time to drop that lure into the open water just at the edge of the pads. Cast after cast. Each one with a hope that there's a big bass lurking back there in the shadows. And there he is. Joan knows when a bass like this strikes and gives that solid, heavy pull, she's hooked supper, if she can land him. The Abu's small, weedless treble has a firm bite in the bass's jaw. The fiberglass rod, with its combination of strength and delicacy, cushions the shocks of the big bass's surges. The Garcia monofilament line can be counted on to hold its specified strength. And the Mitchell is doing its job. Tough luck, old bass. This time you've made a mistake. Try as you will, there's no escape. The Garcia girl's got you, and you're headed for home and the supper table. How can a bass do better than to provide a tempting meal for Joan Salvado, who knows how to bring up youngsters, as well as bring in fish?